Evening. I'm going to say a few words on the play that you're going to see in English. It's called Over the Wall. Here we are with a great wall across our island. Over the Wall is a hilarious piece by James Saunders, a British playwright, where the underlying themes are a search for knowledge, the bliss of ignorance, and the power of tradition. The analogy of an island divided by an impregnable wall is used to delve into the minds and opinions of seven characters and to shed some light on the issue. So I hope you like it.
Sundays.
And we want to work. We didn't have that in the bad old days. We didn't have that in the good old days.
So the content of listening is a rustic content. Now, what made this island different from any other you might have in mind was a wall. We ran across the island a bit more than halfway down, and we had been there for as long as anyone could remember. And as long as anyone they could remember. Forever, in fact, as far as they knew, okay. They call it the wall, and if they ever talked about it, they said things like,
"There's always been a wall, and there always will be. That's the way things are. It's a fact of nature. There's nothing you can do about it.
There must be a purpose in it. That's what I say. Everything has its purpose. Wall, walls, it's all meant.
There are things beyond us, a higher wall, and in will. Someone's in charge up there, the great wall builder in the sky. He knows what's best for us. Leave it to him, that's what I say, or her.
After all, when you think of us human beings crawling on the earth, I mean humility is called for, is not for us to seek to understand the sublime purpose.
Of which the world is past.
Of which the world is past.
It was good enough for my father, and it's good enough for me. That was my father used to say. Leave it at that, he not said.
So they went on with their business, working as they were allowed to through the week, and Saturdays and Sundays working as they were allowed to. Now, what this work, sorry.
This one now was no question.
Yes, as they were allowed to, was what they called the leisure activities. Now this work could always but. Sorry. Was no quite said, but Carlos was so that you could never see the two ends of it together.
Lord, George, the wall goes right round the island.
I know that, Tom. It's a well-known fact.
So they spoke when they fit. and smooth and impregnable, and how it got there, no one knew. There were theories, of course.
There is no doubt that it was constructed in the Neoplasticine age by primitive Triborcipers to enclose the sacred rock of the Earth goddess.
It was built, of course, by invading Venusians as a navigational aid and to protect the species from dinosaurs.
Obviously, a natural outcrop of rock, pushed up by volcanic activity, and then were smoothed by the wind and the rain. An interesting phenomenon.
It's a figment of the imagination. The world only existed on Mars. If we stopped thinking it was there, it wouldn't be.
No one could prove this theory wrong.
I walked into it last night in the dark. Look at the lump on my forehead.
Psychosomatic. You imagine it was there. So when you go to where you imagine it was, you walk into it and imagine your heart yourself. It stands to reason.
Is this hard?
You think it does.
But since it seemed to make not much difference, if you thought you walked into it, whether you were really hard or not thought you were, people tried not to. Except for one poor fellow who so convinced himself that the world was imaginary that he took a flying leap at where it was. Or wasn't, and they sketch branch out, or so it seemed.
Excuse me, I can get in a survey. May I ask what you think is on the other side of the world?
I don't want to talk about this. I think it's disgusting. There is no plastic this side of the world. Never mind the other side of the world.
It's like a beautiful garden with fruit hanging down and pretty flowers. And you don't have to wear any clothes.
Nothing.
Nothing?
Nothing. Everything finishes at the wall. Then there is nothing.
The fifth dimension.
Ethereal vibration.
That is to say, beyond the wall, the laws of space-time, as we know them, no longer operate. Call it the ethereal vibration, call it the fifth dimension, call it a roly-poly pudding.
In other words, as far as we are concerned, it doesn't exist in there. If one can stay in there, fall out there, it doesn't exist, and therefore cannot be said to be either in or there.
As for what doesn't exist, it's like a mathematical point, really.
Like I say, nothing.
Don't know.
Don't know.
Don't know.
Don't care.
So there it was, or wasn't, or was in a different way, or seemed to be.
Mom!
What?
What's over the wall?
You wash your mouth out with soapy water. I'll give you over the wall. Wait till I tell your father.
Dad!
What?
What's over the wall?
As your teacher, what do you think I pay raise and thesis for? To teach you myself?
I asked my teacher.
Well?
Said to get on with my algebra.
Well, then do what the teacher says.
But what is over the wall?
The town, my wood. Get on with your homework.
I done my homework. What's over the wall?
Then do something else. Can't you see I'm trying to work, tell it?
Or whatever it was, they watched in those days. It wasn't
any. Can't you see I'm trying to work the wall fits?
Can you see I'm trying to get this parrot out of my trousers?
Can you see I'm trying to invent the way
to the state, bath the baby, darn my socks,
print a photo of my mother,
write a sonnet, make a fortune,
get my head out from between these wagons,
bury the cat,
see how well I'm starting at the bottom,
or whatever. And so, in short, on the whole, more or less, roughly speaking, in an answer, they ignore it.
Pretending it wasn't there.
Well, no, they couldn't do that, because it was. No, they just ignore it, as you might ignore a guy crashed at a party who nobody knows and nobody wants to, who turns up in the wrong gear with a nasty look on his face at what looks like a flip knife sticking out of one pocket.